I'm Richard Windisch from the Green Mountain Club, and welcome to our video series about hiking with dogs. If you're anything like me, you wouldn't dream of hitting the trail without your dog at your side. This is my friend Jack, and we love nothing more than being out here on the long trail. In this first segment, we'll share some basic tips to help you enjoy your time out on the trail with your dog. Most hikers like to give our dogs some freedom to explore on the trail, if it is allowed. Check the signs at the trailhead to see if there is a specific leash policy for the trail. If permitted to go off leash, you should have good voice command over your dog.
Come here, Jack. Come on, Jack. Let's go.
It is vital that your dog respond to you when called in any situation. We'll talk more about training your dog in part two of this series. No matter how well trained your dog is, it's important to always have a leash with you and to use it at appropriate times. One of those times is when you are on a summit, like here on Mount Mansfield, where there are many other hikers around and the environment is very sensitive.
Well, the alpine sites have vegetation that exists only in three places in Vermont and a few handful of other places in the Adirondacks and the Whites and the remnants of the glacial age. When we didn't have a caretaker program in the early 70s, those places would get trampled with both dogs and humans, so the leashes kind of help make sure that people are staying on the rocks, but also that their pets are too, not just scrambling around, smelling everything, and which is fine in most places, but the vegetation there is very fragile and rare, so we try to do our best to maintain it.
You should also leash when approaching a shelter. You never know who or what might be in the shelter. It's generally respectful to keep your dog from bothering other hikers who may be resting or cooking food, until you introduce the dog and get permission. It's also important to keep your dog away from a shelter water source to prevent contamination.
Get away. Come on.
These water sources are precious to everyone on the trail. Take your dog downstream for drinks or cooling off. These simple precautions will help build and maintain good relations with fellow hikers.
With most things, a lot of it's about maintaining like some semblance of freedom and liberty for other people and not dampening their experience because you want to have your dog out here. So recognizing when when people might be uncomfortable around a dog and making sure you have it on a leash then, and also, under some kind of voice command, if you don't have a leash with you, that'd be very important.
Some people are actually afraid of dogs, and some people, might be really concerned about where the dog is and all sorts of stuff. So it's like you're part of a public interaction when you go out onto the trail, and your role in that is to help other people feel comfortable as well as yourself.
Keep in mind that you and your dog are not the only hikers on the trail. Yielding the right of way when encountering other people on the trail is proper etiquette for dog owners, according to hiker and dog trainer Cassandra Fleury.
I like to think of my dogs as being canine ambassadors and stuff for other dogs on the trail. So for Maggie and Oliver, it's extra important for me that, they go and they sit calmly and allow other people to go by in case those people may not be dog fans, especially if there's kids. If there's ever any elderly people or kids, make sure your dogs are under control so they don't accidentally bop somebody down the mountain. And it makes people smile too when they walk by and say, hey, cool, look at that, dog's so nice and calm.
While a leash is essential in some places, Cassandra points out that there are parts of the trail where a leash can actually be dangerous.
The times I do let her off the leash on mountains is when we get to a rocky scramble. When you get to a place on a trail where there's really steep incline, there's a lot of rocks, you know what? Your dog is really good at picking a route that works best for them. Her being extra small and everything too, I have to let her go and choose her own route. So having that leash off of her, it allows me not to fall down the mountain and allows her to be safer going up.
When choosing a leash to use for hiking, look for one that's about 6 feet long so that your dog doesn't get too far away. A leash that goes around your waist will keep your hands free.
I always keep a leash within easy reach so I can clip it to Jack when necessary.
Retractable leashes like this one are popular with dog owners at home, but they should not be used on the trail.
Retractable flexi leashes, too much danger. They get wrapped around people's legs, they get wrapped around trees, they get wrapped around other dogs. It gives way too much control, lack of control when the dog is off hiking.
Besides a leash, there are several other items that you should make sure to bring along on a day hike.
These are some really great portable bowls that fold out very lightweight, super easy to use, great to put food or water if there's no water source available. I also have a treat tote. It's like a chalk bag for rock climbing. It hooks onto your belt and it's nice for training, and it's also nice to give them quick little bites of energy along the way. I use these nice little chewies because they're easily digested along the trail.
A reliable collar and tag with your address and cell phone number on it are absolutely essential when out in the woods and could mean the difference between finding a lost dog and not.
Jack! Jack!
If you should become separated from your dog, don't panic. Stay calm and stay put. Don't leave the trail to search for your dog.
Jack!
Getting yourself lost in the woods will only make the situation worse.
Jack! Jack!
Remain in the place you last saw the dog and call the dog's name repeatedly. Having a whistle along is a good idea, as the sound of a whistle can travel a lot further than your voice.
Here, Jack!
Stay where you are as long as you can,
Jack!
Leaving yourself enough time to get out of the woods safely.
Jack! Hey, did you see a dog up there?
No, I didn't.
Did you just come from the summit?
Yep.
I just lost my dog. He was here a minute ago, and I'm not sure which way he went.
Tell any hikers who pass you by about your lost dog. Give them your cell phone number so they'll be able to call you if they see your dog further up the trail.
Okay. I also have my cell phone. Would you mind if I gave you my number?
No, no, no.
Maybe you can give me a call?
Okay.
Okay, great. Thank you. Jack!
If you still haven't found your dog by nightfall, contact your local Forest Service ranger and other authorities to report a missing dog. Post flyers with pictures and a description at nearby trailheads. Recruit local assistance using social media on the internet, and organize a search party for the following day in the same place you last saw your dog. Remember, if your dog will not reliably come when called or is known to wander off, it's best to keep your dog on a leash when out on the trail to make sure everyone makes it home safely.
In this first segment, we've covered some of the basics for hiking with dogs: voice command, having a reliable leash, and respect for other hikers. In other parts of this series, we'll dig deeper into training, protecting your dog's health, and long-distance hiking. In the meantime, I hope you and your friend both have a great time out on the trail.